We're continuing one of my favorite subjects, which is fact versus myth. What this one is about is that vaccination does not equal immunization. Now, when you get vaccinated, what happens is it theoretically increases your immune system in whatever way the vaccine is supposed to work. COVID vaccine is a unique entity. Nobody really knows exactly how it's supposed to work. But what's important to understand is that immunization is, if it's documented, that your immune system responds in a particular way. But if your body is depleted internally, if you don't have vitamin D, if you have medical illnesses, if you have genetic challenges, vaccination does not equal immunization, whether it be COVID, whether it be flu, no matter what it is, okay? Now, there's some vaccines in the past that they do equal immunization, but what happens is as we go down the path of life, we become like old computers. No matter how many times you reboot them, they're just not gonna work well. They're gonna work really slowly. And that's the same for your immune system. So what is a critical message for everyone is, in order to better immunize yourself and as an insurance policy for global greater wellness, meaning global meaning your entire body, you must be taking a therapeutic dose of vitamin D. Number one, there's over 4,000 medical studies that show that a therapeutic, meaning that your blood level is high within the normal range. For instance, in the US, the upper limits of normal is 100. I try to keep my patients at 70. In the UK, it's 200. I try to keep them at 150. Or in Europe, that's pretty much the same numbers as well. Glutathione, huge studies that show that glutathione is imperative for anti-COVID. It's also imperative with anti-aging. It's imperative to help if you have pigment, melasma in your skin, if you have acne, any sort of inflammatory condition. Glutathione, essential for helping to prevent and for empowering your immune system. L-lysine, antiviral, whether you have genital herpes, herpes in your mouth, no matter, any sort of virus, L-lysine, very antiviral. Vitamin C, look, we've known forever that vitamin C helps your immune system. It also is imperative for your skin, for anti-aging, for your joints. So vitamin C, essential, and you have to take the right dose. Supplements have to be taken just like medications in the right dose. So what I tell people is you start with 1,000 milligrams a day of vitamin C, and you go up to, look, I've got patients who are taking my alkalized C, which is 4,000 milligrams a teaspoon. They're taking 4,000 milligrams a day. Glutathione, 500 milligrams per lozenge. That's an IV dose, okay? And that's what's gonna help the skin lighten. And it's not that it makes your skin whiter, it just makes whatever color your skin is creamier and more equal. It helps decrease your pore size, it helps decrease your acne. L-lysine, antiviral, no matter what that virus is. Organic sulfur, I'm a huge fan. For your hair, skin, and nails, for your joints, to help keep you from having to need a joint replacement in the future. It's also helps protect against having any of the sequelae of any virus, no matter how strong it is. And it helps get rid of heavy metals, We're all full of lead and mercury nowadays. All those things are what help us stay well, stay younger, slow down the clock, and be more likely immunized, because vaccination does not equal immunization. I've got patients right now who are fully vaccinated for COVID. They've got COVID. They didn't have it before. So go explain that. But those supplements, quercetin, there's a whole list on the website of what I recommended to help protect against COVID or help protect against any of the viruses and cancer, okay? All these things, cancer, look, genetic challenges, people who have eczema, people who have the mold gene, and there are a lot of people who have a gene that makes them more susceptible to mold. There are people who have genes that make them more susceptible to diabetes. All those supplements, Jambola, which helps lower your blood sugar. You lower your blood sugar, it keeps you healthier, keeps you younger, helps keep you from making pigment in your skin. Heart diseases, red yeast rice, time-release niacin, omega fish oil. Omega fish oil helps your immune system. Omega fish oil helps your skin. All of these supplements are more likely to keep you healthier. So understand that just because you're immunized, because you're vaccinated, you still have to be taking your supplementation forever. And people say to me, oh, it's a lot to take. Yeah, it's a lot to take. And the more we go down the path of life, the more we need, because we are old computers that are not working as quickly. Our immune systems, our joints, our collagen production, whether it be in our skin for keeping our eyes open, keeping our muscles strong. That's part of what keeps our eyes open. That's part of what keeps our brains good. It's part of what keeps us from having loose necks, etc. All these things help. Yes, skin products are helping with the anti-aging, but what you take internally is more likely immunizing you against a plethora of diseases. So understand that you have to be clear that wellness, or that being protected, and what I care about is that I'm giving you the best insurance policy against being sick at all, certainly against lying on the bed in an emergency room or having any sort of surgery. So, fact, you may be vaccinated, you're not immunized. Immunization is what comes from you are what you eat, food is your medicine, exercising, trying desperately to be happy. And there's a lot of things that help with that as well, which are on the website, because all those things are equally as important. Your teeth being healthy, all those things are what help you be more likely immunized against all the things that can attack us in this life. I'm trying to help take care of you. Thank you.